From the controversy that ensued after she called a player a racial slur, to working for an Israeli basketball team instead of retiring, here's why Liz Cambage left the WNBA and everything that came after. Although she left the game in 2022, people still can't stop talking about it. And of course they can't. Longtime fans still remember how Liz just abruptly left her team, LA Sparks, while the 2022 season was still going on. Yeah, she didn't even wait for it to wrap up or anything, and obviously that was a huge blow to the team and its fans. As for Liz herself, she announced her decision to leave in an Instagram post, saying that she wanted to take a step back from not just her team, but in fact, the entire league for the time being. She obviously apologized to her colleagues, talking about how playing for them was a dream come true for her, and that sharing the court with all of her incredible teammates is an honor she'll never forget. Liz also wished that her journey with the team would have ended on a better note, but certain circumstances had forced her to leave this way, and it was because of these same circumstances that she also requested the WNBA to create safer environments and a stronger support system for all its players in the same post. Now, by circumstances, I'm obviously referring to the racist controversy that Cambage was caught up in, and she references that in her post as well. She wrote that she'd be using the time off to focus on her mental well-being before she's able to provide any clarification on some rumors about her. And what she's calling a rumor actually dates back to 2021, to a pre-Olympics warm-up game where she called the Nigerian players monkeys. Yeah, that didn't sit well with the fans, and that's not where it ends. Liz was also involved in a verbal and physical dispute with those players, which got so bad that the warm-up game was eventually abandoned. In fact, Liz even elbowed Nigerian center player Victoria McCauley, and that was so bad that it left an actual gash in Victoria's neck. Obviously, the whole thing was pretty serious, and it led to Liz being investigated independently. She was eventually issued a formal reprimand too, but here's the catch. It was just for her physical altercation. So what about the comments that she made? Cause Liz didn't just call them monkeys. She also said a bunch of other problematic stuff, like asking the whole team to go back to their third world country. Yikes! The Nigerian players verified this themselves, with multiple people recalling the use of the word monkeys too. And it was all the more surprising to them, because before the practice game, Liz had actually come up to the Nigerian players and said that she'd rather be playing with them than with her own team, since she was half Nigerian on her dad's side, talking about how her Opal's teammates were very racist as it was. But I guess Liz wasn't any different. It was later revealed that the Opals had their own issues with Liz, with her teammates calling her out for her behavioral issues after many separate incidents. One of them even said that there were so many problems with her that they could probably write a whole book about them. And having followed Liz's career, that's honestly not shocking. But the racism? Now that's a new low, and this time, fans had had enough. They were raging. And Twitter started blowing up as soon as this news hit the world. And people rightly wrote how a racial slur isn't something that people just say on accident or in the heat of the moment because of a brawl or anything. It's always intended, and it reflects deeper issues with the person who's saying that kind of stuff. But what shocked fans the most was how this was coming from Liz, who, like I mentioned, is a woman of color herself. Now, as for Liz herself, she denied saying any of that stuff, but like, of course she did. Who'd own up to something like that? Especially someone like Liz. She posted about the whole thing on Instagram, saying that she was very hurt by all the accusations that the media had put on her. She said that the predominant narrative of what happened in 2021 was false and misleading, and she explicitly denied using any racial slur. Of course, she didn't deny the physical brawl, because that one was caught on video, but she did have her defense for it. Liz wrote that she'd only unintentionally fouled a Nigerian player, after which the player had gotten angry and started physically assaulting her on the sidelines. Liz said that she was hit in the face and pushed to the ground, but she didn't lose her cool. She just walked away. Except she did eventually lose her cool, and we have the Nigerian player's scars to prove it too. But even then, Liz maintained that the whole thing would have been easily avoided if the warm-up game had professional referees present on the court to safeguard both teams. Now, she didn't shy away from saying that she accepted all responsibility for her involvement, but she did kind of remove herself from being involved in any way, didn't she? So, is this even an apology? Most people didn't buy it, and naturally, the controversy only got worse, and fans started dissing Liz every chance they got. It obviously didn't help that she was having internal problems with the Sparks too, and she always called her teammates out for not feeding her the ball enough. And she also did this very publicly, by the way, during film sessions. Of course, while calling her teammates out, Liz very conveniently forgot that her own below-par performance on the court was probably why her teammates didn't give her the ball. Of course, they were all very annoyed at Liz's comments and eventually started force-feeding her the ball, even if it didn't make sense in terms of the play. And naturally, that led to some embarrassing losses for the team. And guess what? Liz was still angry. Yeah, she threw tantrums in locker rooms and shouted at her teammates. But her behavior wasn't the only reason why her team hated her. It was also because they thought she acted extremely entitled to everything. Like, remember how Liz requested to wear the number 8, but since that number was retired to honor former player Delisha Milton Jones, that was denied. And honestly, just the fact that Liz even asked for it while knowing that the number had been retired is pretty awful. She obviously backed down from that soon enough, but that meant she wanted another number, number 1. And as all Sparks fans know, that number belonged to the team's forward player, Amanda Zowie B. But this time, the franchise didn't deny Liz. They actually approached Amanda and asked her about giving her number to Liz. And as anyone would expect, Zowie obviously turned them down. And can you blame her? It's her number, so it obviously means a lot to her. But Liz? She didn't care. She still wanted what she wanted and kept pestering the team about it, even though she'd been informed of Amanda's views. It got so bad that the management eventually had to cave in, and they made the call to give it to Liz. And you know what the worst part is? Zowie didn't even get a call. No, she got to know this through social media. Imagine how disrespected she must have felt. And naturally, the whole team would have hated Liz for it. They saw that the Sparks were playing favorites, and that obviously didn't sit well with anyone. Now, that kind of bitterness can never end well for a team sport, and it's no surprise that Liz felt that her work environment was unhealthy and not supportive. So she left not just the WNBA, but the Aussie national team as well. Yeah, she wasn't repping her country, even though it hosted the FIBER, Women's Basketball World Cup, in 2022. And she has zero plans of doing it in the future. Liz doesn't want to represent Australia anymore, and not just in the World Cup, but the Olympics too. But hey, if she isn't part of the league or national squads, then what is she even doing? Does this mean she's retired? Well, not really, because fast forward to March 2023, about a year after Liz's departure from the WNBA was announced, it was reported that the Aussie player had officially signed with Maccabi Bnei Ashdod, an Israeli basketball team. In signing with Ashdod, Liz has joined the likes of many other WNBA players like Kalani Brown and Natisha Hiedemann, who also signed with this same team. And the team itself has been at the top of the Israeli division, I-League, this past season, even winning the regular season championship title and the cup. I guess Liz is still up and at it. So, from working for an Israeli basketball team instead of retiring, to calling the Nigerian players racial slurs, this was all on Liz Cambage's departure from the WNBA.